Coming up on today's episode of Airborne Unlimited, a Twin Otter and Osprey collide on a ramp, the Cessna Skyhawk turns 65, and Wisk resumes Cora flight testing. I'm Sophie Herlock. On May 30th, a Skydiving Operations DHC-6 Twin Otter collided with a Marine Corps MV-22B Osprey parked on a ramp at Brown Field Municipal Airport in San Diego. Luckily, no one was injured in the incident. However, the accident has been classified by the Marine Corps as a Class A mishap, meaning the estimated damage done is at least $2 million. The Twin Otter airplane, owned by Skydiving Center Kapowowson, had been at the airfield since May 8th for routine maintenance. On the day of the accident, the aircraft was being picked up by pilot Christopher Sanders to be used at a nearby airstrip for skydiving. According to Sanders, when he got the aircraft, the right and left engine turned on without an issue, and the aircraft began to roll forward. He then went to check the parking brake, pressed on the brakes, and they were unresponsive. It was then that the Twin Otter moved left and hit the Osprey on the left wing, engine, and propeller blade with its nose and left and right propellers, causing extensive damage to both aircraft. Both the Marine Corps and the FAA are both investigating the accident. However, the investigation will likely take a few weeks to complete. Stick around, because when we return, we'll have information on the latest cancellation in the aviation world due to COVID-19.
Sandia introduces the new SAI 340 Quattro TSO'd airspeed, attitude, altitude, and slip. With integral backup battery, safety never looked so good. See it now at www.sandia.aero.
Affordable and economical, Pipistrel is proud to present the Alpha Trainer. Offering excellent fuel efficiency and a durable composite design, the Alpha Trainer can be operated from virtually anywhere. Whether you're a first-time aircraft owner, assembling a fleet, or running a flight school, the Light Sport Alpha Trainer from Pipistrel is a dynamic option. Learn more about what the Pipistrel Alpha Trainer can do for you at pipistrel-usa.com.
Like most of you, we're still working from home. We miss being around pilots.
But the most important thing right now is to mitigate your risks and use this time productively while we all get through this.
Folks, King Schools is open and we're 100% operational. We're making sure that your courses work and are available for you 24/7.
We look forward to the time when we can see you again at the airport.
Welcome back. It's time for today's trip around the patch. The Canadian Forces CF-18 Hornet demo team has decided to cancel their 2020 season due to the uncertainty surrounding the COVID-19 pandemic. The decision comes after most of the air shows in their 2020 schedule had been canceled, and the need to protect the health and safety of their spectators and team members. The team says they'll be looking for other ways to interact with all their fans throughout the year. On June 4th, Boeing sent a letter to Spirit AeroSystems, one of their contractors, to pause additional work on four 737 MAX chipsets and to avoid starting production on 16 chipsets to be delivered this year. The order was given to support the new needs of Boeing customers due to COVID-19's impact on the aviation industry and a cutback on potential unnecessary production costs. Spirit estimates the 2020 737 MAX production plan of 125 chipsets will be reduced by more than 20 chipsets. Hilton Software won a five-year, $4 million contract from the FAA to provide continued software and data support for the FAA's flight program operations. The contract is part of an effort to ensure that the FAA's flight program operations have the tools they need to safely analyze new and current instrument approach procedures on the ground and in flight with regards to terrain, vertical obstructions, missed approach procedures, and other aspects of influencing the safety of flight. The United States Space Force's Space and Missile Systems Center's GPS-3 program reached a major milestone with the successful core mate of GPS-3 Space Vehicle 08. With core mate complete, the space vehicle was named Katherine Johnson in honor of the NASA mathematician and human computer who designed and computed orbital trajectories for NASA's Mercury, Apollo, and Space Shuttle missions. The next step for the Katherine Johnson is the post-mate systems performance test, scheduled to begin in August, which will electrically test the performance of the satellite during the early phase of build. GPS-3 Space Vehicle 08 is currently scheduled to launch in 2022. We'll be right back with the rest of the news.
There's a difference between charting a steady course and pushing for the ceiling. And for nearly a century, Hartzell Propeller has been defining that difference. It's in our passion for engineering and research and our dedication to testing the limits of performance. We are built on honor. We are Hartzell Propeller.
Swift Fuels proudly introduces the Forever Avgas STC. One simple upfront purchase entitles the Forever STC certificate holder to receive all current and future Avgas STCs that the FAA issues to Swift Fuels. The best part? It's priced today at only $100, and the prepaid certificate never expires. Get your Forever Avgas STC today at SwiftFuelsAvgas.com.
Last Friday, Textron celebrated the 65th anniversary of the first flight of the Cessna Skyhawk, one of the most popular single-engine aircraft in aviation history. Since the aircraft first took to the sky, more than 45,000 Skyhawks have been delivered to customers around the world, more than any other aircraft in the industry. On June 12, 1955, the Cessna Skyhawk took to the skies for the first time, paving the way for more than six decades of piston innovation and leadership. Today, the Skyhawk remains an integral part of Textron Aviation's pilot outreach efforts, with programs like Top Hawk, which enables budding pilots to begin their flying journey. For the past 5 years, the program has connected student pilots from flight schools and universities across the U.S. with a factory new Cessna Skyhawk for next-generation flight training. Textron Aviation also donates Discovery flights to local community organizations. This year, Textron Aviation was awarded a contract by the U.S. Civil Air Patrol for 17 Cessna piston engine aircraft, and among the aircraft were 11 Skyhawk 172s. Wisk's Cora has resumed flight testing in both the U.S. and New Zealand after taking a brief pause due to COVID-19. The flight test will evaluate the performance of the aircraft in real-world environment while collecting data that will help inform the further development, operation, safety features, and certification of the aircraft. Prior to the pandemic, the company had completed more than 1,300 test flights, expanding the flight envelope, providing data for model, design, and requirement updates, and manufacturing procedures to operate the aircraft safely and efficiently. Gary Gysin, CEO of Wisk, stated, "The team's dedication over the past few months has allowed us to remain focused on critical non-flight areas, such as certification, software development, and operations. This has allowed us to maintain momentum during this unique time, but it's awesome to be flying again." And that wraps up our show, everyone. Don't forget to click subscribe and to check us out on Facebook and on Twitter. For more aviation and aerospace news any time of the day, head over to aero-news.net. Thanks for watching. I'll see you again on Wednesday.